As one of the last PhD of Tim, and unfortunately I was abroad when he passed away, so I never got to say goodbye to him. And I prepare a little speech to say goodbye and to share with him. So this is a eulogy for my friend.
Okay,
so in fact, I did took classes with Tim. I was 21 years old, and by advice of Jorge Ise, I ended up sitting in front of him for the first time. The name of the course, Special Functions and Integral Transforms. That was such a wild name. Tim was a renowned professor. He was famous for his intelligence and his roughness. The word was that only geniuses and fools would take classes with him, and I am no genius. What a shock, you know, was to see him walk into the classroom. He was around 6 feet tall, a full set of gray hair, and a fantastic smile. And he greeted us. "Hello, little bunnies," because that's what we were to him. Little bunnies. "Whoever derives Schrödinger's equation, I will take for an ice cream." Derive? I thought, is it that Schrödinger's equation can be derived? I was stunned. Damian, a good friend of mine and a classmate, probably had the same thought because he let a weird and mocking sound, like air escaping from a balloon, slide from his mouth. It is fair to say that Damian wasn't a genius either. So Tim turned around and with a frown face asked Damian to step in front of the class. He said to him, "Little bunny, derive Schrödinger's equation." "Pardon," Damian repeated. "Derive Schrödinger's equation, and I'll take you for an ice cream." With visible nervousness, Damian started mumbling about the energy operator and the moment operator, and that if you square I and the what operator? What are you talking about? Tim interrupted. "Don't you know the origin of Schrödinger's equation?" Silence. "Little bunnies," he said, "do any of you know the origin of Schrödinger's equation?" That's it. "I'll take you for an ice cream," he said mocking. After 1 or 2 minutes without an answer, Tim left the room a little angry. Next class, I was very worried. What if he called me in front of the class? Who was this man? Where did all his broad yet to the point questions came from? What an idea. On time as usual, Tim walked into the classroom with big steps and a little book, The Physical Principles of the Quantum Theory by Werner Heisenberg. He stood still for a little while, flipped the book briefly, and began. "In order to understand the origin of Schrödinger's equation, one must know the context in which it was derived. What was happening at the time? Who was working on what? It is no wonder that de Broglie proposed the wave nature of electrons. After all, Frenchmen have a great school in waves. On the other hand, Germans were trying to solve great problems of the time and with classical mechanics. And to understand the way of thinking, it's only necessary to open Sommerfeld's book on the subject." And so he began explaining every reasoning, every assumption, every step, until 2 hours later, with the board full of equations and his face full of chalk, because that was Tim also, he wrote, in all its glory, Schrödinger's equation. It was amazing. Filled with emotion, I thought, this man is a magician. And then I realized, oh, so that's why we are his little bunnies. Later that semester, while I was struggling to understand that obscure object, so familiar to Tim, that is green Green's function, I had the audacity to attack the counter-integral of a solution written in integral form, such as Kim did in class, and without almost any understanding, completely blind, I pushed the calculations until I was able to apply the residue theorem and to produce a student's mini version of the spectral theorem with continuous spectrum and all, and I stood mesmerized. In that moment, my universe transformed. It became infinitely bigger. Don't get me wrong, I still didn't understand the thing, but at that instant, my heart told me that something great had happened. To this day, when I teach the Green function to my students, and we talk about the connection between linear algebra and differential operators, and about the consequences of working in infinite dimensions and the richness that emanates from this, I can hear their hearts through their awe. Something great is happening, they say. So that was Tim. That was Tim for me, a kind friend, a true master, capable of teaching infinities with mathematics that could make a heart speak. Thank you.
Let's go for coffee and we should be back at 10:45.